Hello friends, so in this video lecture we try to understand and set up the polymerase chain reaction. So for the polymerase chain reaction certain instruments are required. The first is the machine which is called thermocycler. So this is the thermocycler, so you need to have a thermocycler first. Then you need to have the quick spin. This is the quick spin, right? So you can just make the your mixture quick spin. And then you need to have the pipettes, different range of the pipettes depending upon your use. Then electrophoretic apparatus you need to have. And other things what you need to have is the different enzymes, then DNTPs, then TAC DNA polymerase, so different chemicals are required. So before starting the experiment, first of all you need to quick spin the enzymes or the components which you are going to use for the PCR, right? So that it will settle down at the base, right? And you will get the required chemical very easily, right? So this is the quick spin, right? So now the quick spin is completed. So I'm transferring this chemical or this reagents of the PCR to the ice. So always keep your solutions or reagents in the ice, right? So this is the ice box. This is the PCR reaction mixture, or you can say the cocktail of the reaction for the PCR, and this is made for the 50 microliter, okay? So now we make the PCR reaction mixture. So first component is Milky water, and this is 30.5 microliter. So I am taking here 30.5 microliter, right? This is Milky water, and as such no need of sterile condition is there during the setup of PCR. This is the, you know, PCR cups. So I am putting Milky water here with the help of wall of the microfuse tube, right? Always you discard the tips. Then second component is 10x assay buffer, and 10x assay buffer is 5 microliter. So I am setting my pipette at 5 microliter. This is 5 microliter. This is 10x assay buffer. Okay, so 10x assay buffer I am putting here. 5 microliter. Okay. You first close it properly. Mm-hmm. You mix it very, very carefully with the help of wall of the microfuse tube. Okay, mix it properly. Now discard the tip. Okay, the third component is template DNA. This is 2 microliter. So this is template DNA. Okay. First you close it. So you can just hold like this and you can put it here. So this is 2 microliter template DNA. Okay, mix it properly. Then next is 1 microliter forward primer. So 1 microliter of forward primer. This this is the third chemical, that is forward primer. So this is very less amount, so be careful during the pipetting. See, very minute amount. You can just hold this and you can put your forward primer here. Okay. So after forward primer, then reverse primer is there. So then fourth component is reverse primer. So this is reverse primer. So reverse primer I am adding. Same, 1 microliter, 1 microliter of the reverse primer. Again you hold it like this and okay. Then after reverse primer, then 25 millimolar magnesium chloride, and this is 5 microliter, so I'm setting again on 5 microliter. This is 5 microliter. Okay. So this is 25 millimolar magnesium chloride. So put this. All right. Okay. Next is DNTPs, that is 2.5 millimolar and 5 microliter is there. So this is set on 5 microliter itself. So this is 2.5 millimolar DNTPs. So all the nucleotides are here, all 4 nucleotides. For the synthesis of new strand of the DNA. So this is 5 microliter. So 5 microliter DNTPs has been added. Right, mix it well. Always you mix it well, right? Mixing is very important. Okay. Okay. Then last is tac DNA polymerase, and this tac DNA polymerase is 0.5 microliter. So 0.5 microliter you set this pipette. This is very very less amount. So a special pipette is also there, and you can lock this pipette like this, right? And you take now. So this is tac DNA polymerase, which is extracted from the thermos aquaticus, you know very well. This is thermostable DNA polymerase, right? This is heat resistant DNA polymerase. So see the amount, very very less amount. Okay, so very less amount. And finally I am adding this tac DNA polymerase. Mix it properly. Okay. And once you added these, you know, components, then you mix it properly. And then now we put onto the thermocycler. So now I have made 10 such reactions here, and I'll set this 10 reaction mixture into the PCR. So just now I have started the PCR, and one can run 96 PCR here simultaneously, right? So you can put any sample anywhere, no problem, because numbering is there, right? So you can remember the numbering. A, B, C, D, and 1, 2, 3 is written over there, right? And one more thing, we have not added mineral oils on the surface or on the top of the cocktail, right? That 50 microliter cocktail, because this PCR have hot plate at the top, right? So there is no need to add mineral oil over here, right? So now I keep the cocktail, 10 cocktails or the samples here, and now I'm closing this lid, right, and put it like this. And now you just set the programming. So we know very well 3 cycles are there, right? So 3 cycles in the PCR are there. So here you can set the cycle. You can run, create, edit. It depends. This key or this touch, it depends upon the make to make, right? So here, if we wish to create some new program, so here is the initial denaturation, right? This is for 94 degree centigrade for 5 minutes, right? So this will occur once, and then 3 cycles of the PCR. This is denaturation. This is initial denaturation, right? And this is denaturation. This is then annealing. The primer will anneal. And this is the amplification. So annealing at 55 degree centigrade at 30 minutes, right? And here this is extension, which is at 72 degree centigrade for 30 seconds, okay? And this is the final phase, that is the final extension. Here it is set at 72 degree centigrade for 7 minutes, okay? And after the completion, then automatically this machine will go at 4 degrees centigrade for the infinite time. So just I'm starting. So this program is all right for us, right? And suppose if you wish to change depending upon your primer, you can change, right? So I'm going to start. So here I'm pressing F1. So this is started. So now they are asking volume. So yeah, we have 50 microliter. Otherwise you can change the volume, right? So now I'm starting, right? So this button, it will start, okay? So see, now it will run for 5 minutes, that is initial denaturation, and then we'll enter into this cycle, right? And we have set 35 cycles, so it will run 35 cycles, complete 35 cycles after enters into the final extension, and then we can keep out and we'll run the gel. PCR run is completed, all the 35 cycle has been completed, so now I'm opening. And you just remove the tray, right? And we'll load the gel. So now I'm loading the sample that PCR has been done, and now I'm loading, right? So you mix the gel loading buffer in appropriate amount according to the protocol, and you can load like this, okay? Now we rain the gel. And after running the gel, now we can put onto the UV transilluminator. So we can put this entire tray also, and now you can see the result, right? Okay, so the amplification takes place. Otherwise, if you wish to get the good picture, then you can just pull it out, right? You can pull it out from the like this, see. So this is the PCR amplified product, right? So the first one is the ladder, right? And these are the different reactions, okay? And why the bands are above and below? Because, you know, the time when we loaded the sample, we started the current, right? So last sample we loaded, as we loaded last sample, so first sample has been drained already too much, that's why. That's it. So I think it would help you a lot. Thank you.